Okay, let's talk to the doctor again a little bit more here. With regard to nuclear energy, obviously I'm old enough to remember when they made it just a horrible thing and all but shut it down. We still have a nuclear power plant in my district. One right outside of my district had to be closed. I wondered if you could comment on the amount of pollutants in the air today because of we've replaced all these nuclear power plants, how much pollution we have because of it if we hadn't decided to shut off the nuclear energy, and the motivation, you think, of the people who 30 years ago did movies, that sort of thing, to kind of end that line of providing energy. Mr. Schellenberger.
Thank you, Congressman, and for that question. And by the way, that nuclear plant in Wisconsin did not need to be closed down. Nuclear plants can be, American nuclear plants, not all nuclear plants, can be refurbished. And in fact, they regularly are, to run for 80 years or longer. You might have to replace turbines. At some point, you might have to replace the reactor core. But these 60 or so sites around the United States, for anybody who cares about climate change, should be the basis for deep decarbonization, because you can simply expand the number of reactors on a given site. Also, my view is that the used fuel is best stored on site. In terms of how much pollution was created by the effort to shut down nuclear, well, you may recall that in the 50s, 60s, and even early 70s, there were people that wanted to have 50% of our electricity from nuclear. Today, we get just 20%. Every time a single nuclear reactor shuts down, it's the equivalent of putting about 1 million new cars on the road. So if you get rid of our roughly 100 nuclear reactors in the United States, it's like adding 100 million cars to the road, in terms of CO2 emissions, by the way. I mentioned a study in Nature Energy in 2017. It found that closing nuclear plants reduced birth weight significantly. And so I'm sort of surprised to hear the people on this, the witnesses here, talking about being concerned about communities of color and poor communities, and not mentioning at all that the closure of nuclear plants has directly affected low birth weight. And that was a peer-reviewed study in Nature Energy. We similarly saw in both Fukushima now and in Japan and Germany after the Fukushima accident, the closure of nuclear plants resulted in greater air pollution alongside higher electricity costs. The motivations, I'm afraid, have not been positive motivations. There's a generalized fear of nuclear energy associated with fear of nuclear weapons, but it was manipulated starting in the 1960s, and I described this in great detail in my book and elsewhere, by the Sierra Club. And it came from this idea that nuclear energy was bad because it allowed for abundant energy, that energy basically eliminates scarcity. With nuclear energy, there is no climate crisis. If we simply had scaled up nuclear energy in the 50s and 60s, as many of us imagined we would, we wouldn't be having this conversation today. If every country had done what France had done, we wouldn't be having this conversation today. With abundant, infinite energy, effectively, you get infinite fresh water, infinite fertilizer, and infinite food. And the people that opposed it, both here in my home state of California and around the world, explicitly said that we should not have cheap and abundant energy because of what humans would do with it. And so at the end of my testimony, you may note that I have a passage where I note that environmental policy has been influenced enormously by some very reactionary ideas, I think, that are very anti-human ideas that suggest that humans are a cancer on the earth and that we need to stop the spread of that cancer by reducing the amount of, by making food and energy and including housing more expensive. And I think that this is totally wrong. We know that with abundant clean energy, we can also concentrate agriculture, leaving more of the earth for other species. We can significantly reduce air pollution. There's a lot of good news. There's a very positive future. This idea that we need to go terrify school children in order to reduce air pollution, or the claims that somehow these reductions in air pollution occurred because we scared people, or we engaged in this kind of alarmism, is just false. We did so because we actually believed in progress. So that's the heart of the move against nuclear, and I see it in this climate discourse. It's inaccurate, it's exaggerated, and in many cases, I think it's quite extreme. And a positive pro-nuclear future, I think, points to ways in which we can achieve both human flourishing and environmental progress.